and connect up with them. Kayla Ritchie is joining us, and she has some furry friends with her right now. Good morning, Kayla. How are you?
Good morning. How are you? I'm good.
Good. Now, who are we talking about here this morning that needs a new home?
Yeah, this is Sheila. I don't know if you can see her right now. Before the camera turned on, she was over here giving me some love. And then as soon as the camera came on, she went and hid in her box. A little camera shy. She's about 2 years old, about 6 pounds. She's really sweet. She's just a little slow to trusting people. So you got to give her own time to come around to you. But once you do, she loves cuddles. She loves giving head bumps. She loves sitting on your shoulder. And once she starts purring, she actually starts drooling. It's really cute.
That's how you really know a kitty cat is into it, if they start doing that, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow, so what a neat animal here. Absolutely gorgeous. Now, we're talking about adopting the animals out, and one of the things about people being at home a lot is, you know, this is one of the things we didn't really foresee, is that a lot of people have been adopting animals, haven't they?
Yeah, we've actually had really high adoption numbers and low in-shelter numbers, which is awesome.
Yeah, that's the way we want to see it continue, and hopefully people will continue that trend now. But the way that people can check out these animals, it is a little different than they had to do before. Explain the process of someone coming out and checking out, like Sheila, for example. How would they see Sheila?
Yeah, it's a little different. Instead of just walking in, you're going to need to book an appointment, and you can do that right on our website on the main page. There'll be a little option for that. And then once you get here, we do ask if you are able to wear a mask. And we are limiting it to 2 people to see the animals at a time from that group, just so we can eliminate as much social interaction as possible during this time.
Right. Now, just for a second, we are showing your website there for a second. And the cat that you have behind you, Sheila, she obviously thinks people are essential. And you guys have some shirts that are available too, that if you haven't seen these yet, folks, if you're a cat lover, they have one for cats. If you're a dog lover, they have one for dogs. And it basically says, my cat thinks I'm essential, or my dog thinks I'm essential. And where can we get those? Those look pretty cool. I need to get one of those and wear it here.
Yeah, I believe there is a link to pre-order that on the website, and I think they are going to be delivered around mid-June.
Okay.
What I know.
So get them ordered, and then you can pick them up over at the Rescue League too. Save yourself some shipping, which would be the best thing to do there. So get online, get those, because I believe $9 from every shirt sale goes to help the animals at the Animal Rescue League, which is really a cool thing. Now, the cat behind you, Sheila, she is a house cat. There's no question about that. But Animal Rescue League also has barn cats. Now, I want you to explain the difference between a house cat and a barn cat.
Yeah, so the cats in our Camp Purr program, which is our barn cat program, are feral or semi-feral. And that just means they weren't really socialized when they were younger. So they're not going to want to be pet, touched, picked up, stuff like that. And they're really happiest outside. They're
okay, why would somebody want one of these kind of cats? Why would you want a barn cat or a feral type cat?
They are great mousers, so they're great for people that live on farms, on acreages, stuff like that. They can just coexist with you. You feed them their food, they catch the mice for you, and hang out in your barn.
All right, now that's one of the things that we want to make sure is that they hang out in your barn, and there's a certain procedure that you want to let people know about. You can't just get one of these cats and bring it home and then let it go. You have to let that kitty cat know that this is their new home, and there's a little process that you want to explain, right?
Yeah, yeah. So we have a 4 to 6 acclimation period that we require adopters to do. And during that time, you're just going to want to keep them enclosed, whether that's in the barn, in a shed you have on your property, just somewhere they can't get out and roam the property for that 4 to 6 weeks. And during that time, their food, litter, water, it's all going to be in there. And you're really going to want to load them up on some nice high quality food like tuna, wet cat food, chicken table scraps, stuff like that.
Oh, you're gonna bribe them, aren't you? You're gonna let them know here's all the good stuff, right?
Yep, because then once you let them out after that 4 to 6 weeks, they know that's where their resources are and that's home base, and they're gonna come right back even if they wander.
Wow, that is really, now about these cats, these barn cats, so to speak, what kind of things have been done to the cats? Have they been spayed and neutered?
Yep, they are all spayed and neutered. They have their rabies vaccinated and other vaccinations done, and they are microchipped.
Oh, they are.
They do. Yeah. So if they do wander too far and someone else finds them, they can be linked right back to you.
Oh, that is so neat. And you mentioned the animals getting adopted at a higher rate than normal, which is really one of the greatest things of all. But when it comes to barn cats, do you have these animals in the regular building itself, or do you have them out in the barn area over at the Rescue League?
Yeah, they are at our main location, but they're in the area we call the caddy shacks, which are these cool little sheds that they're able to go inside and outside of, so they're acclimated to that outside weather, so you can adopt them at any time of the year.
That is great. Now, you have cats, so we talked a lot about cats, and the dog situation over at the Rescue League right now, how is that stacking up?
I think it's pretty similar to cats. We have really low dog numbers right now and high adoptions for them as well, so it's really great.
All right, and the people that do live on farms and you maybe have some room for some farm-type animals, let people know that you have those type of animals available, too, over at the main office.
Yeah.
There you go. All right, so people want more information about Sheila and the Barn Cat Program and how to make an appointment to come out and see everything. How can they go about doing so?
So for those regular appointments for people like Sheila or cats like Sheila, you're going to go to our main website. You can also find my contact information on the website. It is kricci, K-R-I-C-C-I, at arl-iowa.org. And I'm going to be the one you go to set up barn cat appointments.
There you go. And don't forget, Raise Your Paw Auction on July 11th. It's game on, same bat location downtown. So take advantage of that. We're going to be there with bells on, silent auction, live auction, 5 p.m. at the Iowa Event Center. We are looking forward to that. So we wish you a lot of success here getting the barn cats adopted. Thank you so much for everything you guys do at the Animal Rescue League. We love you guys.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
All right, see you guys later. Bye-bye.